In this video, I'll show you some ways to help recognize your PLLs more quickly. Something that many people often struggle with initially is being able to recognize the PLL case that they have quickly. You don't want this to be a mechanical process, and after a while, you don't really want to be thinking hard about the case that you have. With enough practice, you should be able to subconsciously see a case and execute the algorithm for it. Again, this is something you just need to practice and develop naturally, but here are some quick examples of things you can look for to help you get comfortable with recognizing the PLLs. And then you should also go away and figure out your own ways of recognizing PLL cases. So for example, for something like this, where we have a block containing two edge pieces and one corner piece, there are three possible PLL cases that this can be. Either we have the V permutation, which looks like this, where you have two corners that need to be swapped diagonally like that, and then two edges that need to be swapped there. Or you have one of the two A permutations, where the edges are completely solved and you just need to cycle three corners, like in those two cases. If, for example, we have a three-piece block plus another corner, so a four-piece block, that means we just have one of the two possible J permutations. It's also useful to be able to quickly recognize whether you have diagonally swapped corners, such as this case, or corners that need to be swapped adjacent to one another, so that in your head, once you notice whether it's diagonal or an adjacent swap of corners, you can reduce the number of cases that it could possibly be, and you're only thinking within a subset of PLL cases. The G permutations can be quite hard to recognize at the start, and the easiest way to recognize them and differentiate between them is like this. So if you hold the solved corner in the front right position, you'll either have a block here with the edge in the front, or you'll have a block here with the edge in the right. For the cases where the block is in the same position, like so, the way to recognize them is to look for the matching corners. So there'll be two matching corner stickers like this. They'll either be adjacent to this block, like so, or they'll be on the opposite side to the block, as per this case. So the four G permutation cases are as follows. So this first case here, you'll have the block at the front and the matching corners adjacent to it on the left. The next case, you'll have the block on the front again, but the matching corners are opposite it on the back, like that. The third case you can have is where the block is on the right here and the matching corners are adjacent to it over here, like that. And the last case is again where you have the block on the right, but the matching corners are opposite the block over here, like this. So that's a few tips to help differentiate between individual PLL cases and recognize them, but I'll leave it up to you to go on further and explore your own ways of recognizing PLL cases.